मेरा अगला पड़ाव था सरिखोसोर। ये खतलों प्रदेश का एक रोमांचक स्थल है। मैंने इसे बचपन में देखा था और आज कई सालों बाद देखकर बड़ी खुशी हुई। यहाँ की नदी, हरियाली और झरने सबका मन मोह लेते हैं।
The place is popular as a picnic spot. People come over here to enjoy the weekends. There is a beautiful resort in the area. The Sarikosor Reserve is very rich in the mountain forests consisting of the walnut trees. The forest is full of brown bear, the wild boar, the mountain goat, etc. And they are also used for professional hunting. It is one of the most picturesque places of the Republic. The city of Kulob stood on one of the great Silkway branches and had close trade and economic and cultural links with many Oriental and Western countries. During the Middle Ages, the city of Kulob was an important political, economic and cultural center. Various crafts and trades were developed there. Literary and scientific clubs were very popular. In the 17th to 19th centuries, 40 famous poets lived and created their works in this region. Right in the center of Kulob, near the Museum of Regional Studies, surrounded by century-old sycamores, is this mausoleum of the prominent 14th century poet, philosopher and thinker, Mir Syed Ali Hamadani. Mir Syed's son Muhammad, sisters, relatives, as well as the former custodian of the mausoleum and mosque, Sheikh Shohid Talukwar, are also buried over here. This is a mausoleum that connects three countries, India, Pakistan and Tajikistan, with deep-rooted historical and cultural ties.
ताजिकिस्तान में आकर यहाँ के पोशाकों के बारे में बात ना करूँ तो ज़्यादती होगी। कुर्ते चकान और उनके ऊपर की गई गुलदुजी इनमें चार चांद लगा देती है, और वही अतलस से बने हुए कपड़ों को भला आप कैसे भूल सकते हैं।
This art has ancient roots, and Tajiks do this using special needles and cotton, woolen and silk threads, as well as precious and semi-precious stones. Fargona Valley lies in the north of Tajikistan. The Tajik part is known as Sugd and the capital is Khujan. Fargona Valley has a very glowing past. The great Mughal Emperor of India, Babur, was born in Fargona Valley in the part of region that now comes under Uzbekistan. The main attractions of this region are Istarafshah and Khujan. Istarafshah is famous for its ancient citadels and old townships. While moving inside the city, I was fascinated by its magnificent mosques. Even buildings of some madrasas reminded the old rich history of this region because of their ornate structures and grandeur. Istarafshah is in fact one of the most interesting cities in the whole of Tajikistan. The old city or Sheher-e-Kohuna in Istarafshah has interestingly retained much of its older charm. This town is distinguished by one fact that it has special localities for different craftsmen, like one colony for ironsmith, another for goldsmith, and yet another for artisans and other craft persons. Panjiken, the city of five villages, is located in Khujan area of Tajikistan, in a picturesque Zarafshan River Valley. Quite possibly, the five villages started the history of this remarkable city, which originated in the 5th to 8th centuries AD. Panjikent of that time was one of the most important cultural and craft centers of Sooth.
पुरानी सभ्यताओं की परंपरा इस प्रदेश से भी जुड़ी हुई है। करीब 6000 साल पुरानी इस सभ्यता के कुछ ऐसे अवशेष मिले हैं जिनसे इंडो-आर्यन सभ्यता के विकास पर रोशनी पड़ती है।
The Sarazam Museum is best place to know the elaborate details of the past history of this region and to see the relics of that time preserved and well documented in this place. The site is preserved as a heritage village. A visit to this museum was a must part of our journey. It shows the civilization existed 5500 years before. The Seven Lakes or Haftkul is located in the westernmost part of the Fan Mountains. They are easily accessible from Panjikent. Set in a rough and barren mountain landscape, the Seven Beauties of Shing, as they are called, is a picturesque sight. As per an old local tale, they change their color according to the daylight. The sixth lake, Margzor, is both the biggest and the most beautiful of all. The starting point for most excursions is the village of Shing, where accommodation and transports like porter donkeys are available. They are multicolored lakes with iridescent water ranging in color from a gentle green to a deep lilac. Some even refer to them as one of the seven wonders of the natural world. Cairo Qum is a famous picnic spot where nature lovers and people from far off areas come to entertain and enjoy. The scenery here is spectacular and food and drinks are superb. It is a place where you can pass quality time right in the benevolent lap of nature. One can see the tourists enjoying the water sports. A ride in the cruise boat is a delightful feast to the eyes to experience the natural beauty God has bestowed in this part of the earth. Khujan is the capital of northern Tajikistan and the second largest city in the country. One of the ancient cities of the Central Asia, Khujan has been known since the 7th century. In the 19th century, Khujan became the central district of rapid industrial development. Khujan is attractive to tourists due to its numerous ancient monuments. The most known are the mosque and the mausoleum of Sheikh Muslihiddin. On the north side, a famous historical museum is located.
संग्रहालय सुख दौर की समय की याद को ताज़ा कर देता है। इतिहास और संस्कृति का अद्भुत नमूना इस संग्रहालय में जैसे जीवंत हो गया हो।
This museum is a perfect place to learn and discover the Stone Age era and the lifestyle of human race in ancient times. The vaulted high ceiling and covered areas with nice proportions have created harmonious columns of cool, favorable shopping place. Tajiks are very fond of good food and drinks. Their meal is not complete without a lot of seasonal fruits and dry fruits. Vegetables are not usually part of a Tajik meal. Rather, they prefer non-vegetarian items of a large variety and relish their foods. Similarly, they also are fond of dried fruits like almond, cashew nuts, dried plums, dried dates, cranberries, blueberries, cherries, strawberries, figs, pistachios, raisins, and walnuts. Tajikistan is very accessible by air route. Dushanbe, the capital city of Tajikistan, has a very well-managed modern airport which receives most of the international flights. Domestic airlines in Tajikistan are also very good in terms of ease and services. There are regular services from Dushanbe to other parts of the country. Along with the growth of tourism industry in Tajikistan, hotels and hospitality industries are also fast picking up the momentum. Presently, Tajikistan has already great hotels, resorts, spas and tourist spots. With the arrival of more and more tourists and rising demands, many new hotels and resorts are being built in every region. For instance, Dushanbe, the capital city of Tajikistan, offers one of the best stays as it has many world-class hotels. The hospitality in Tajikistan is amazing. Staffs are super polite, very careful with all requests, ready and available all the time. The decorations are mostly very elegant. Foods which are offered at the multi-flavored food joints of the hotels at Tajikistan are very delicious. The hospitality in Tajikistan is amazing. Staffs are super polite, very careful with all requests, ready and available all the time. The decorations are mostly very elegant. The restaurants offer great food and drinks. There are spas and saloons and gift shops. One can enjoy a five-star experience even in economy class hotels. The arts and crafts of Tajikistan have always been famous all over the world. The intricate design of the carpets, cloths, and other handicraft items are visual delights and attract the buyers from far off places. People come here to buy these items. Especially the carpets are great in their aesthetics, softness and designs. It is considered as a prized item and is very affordable cost-wise. After this wonderful tour, I am really feeling very different, more humble and elevated. My spirit is soaring literally to the rooftop of the world. Though being a Tajiki girl, Tajikistan has been an unforgettable experience to me. It has given me memories that I would cherish all my life. I wish to come here again and again to experience its evolution. There is so much to see and experience in this beautiful mountainous country that leaves one to desire for more and more. It is a land of great contrast and diversity. I was truly struck by its beauty and charm, and equally by humbleness and sweetness of its people. No wonder that Tajikistan is called the crown of the world.
Iski tehzeeb noorani, iski tareekh purani, sun lo duniya walo, sun lo hum sab hai Tajikistani.
अमन का परचम थामे
सुन लो दुनिया वालों सुन लो हम सब हैं ताजिकिस्तानी
इसकी